Hello students, welcome you all in our, I think it may be last lecture of this chapter, lecture number 5, and now we are going to discuss about generators. We have two types of generator, AC generator and DC generator. Till now we are studying about Faraday law. We have two Faraday's law. I just recall you for recall that all. First one is, whenever there is some change in magnetic flux, it will cause two induced EMF in the coil. And second one is, it is also follow the reverse property. It means if the direction of magnetic field will reversed, direction of current induced will also reversed. Okay. And the next thing which we studied earlier, that is Fleming right hand rule. It means we have to stretch our first finger, middle finger and thumb in such a way so that thumb will give the direction of motion. First finger will give the direction of magnetic field and this middle finger will give the direction of induced current. They must be mutually perpendicular to each other. So these things we have to use in our DC or AC generator. I think you know what is AC and what is DC. AC generator, that which generate alternating current, which you know what is alternating current and what is direct current. Alternating current is that current in which value of potential with respect to time is changing regularly like this. This is our alternating current. But for direct current, this is AC. And for direct current, the value of potential with respect to time is remains same. It does not change. Okay, so this is the difference between alternating current and direct current. It's, we can say in India, its frequency is 50 hertz and its frequency is always zero. Its frequency is zero anywhere because in direct current the value of potential does not change. Okay, so let's come. Actually, I just relate one thing. It will help you that electric motor which is in your syllabus and AC. Sorry, DC generator, they both are in syllabus and they are very much easy to learn them because they are exactly opposite in, okay, let me draw the diagram. This is our permanent magnet, north, south. This is our armature and this is our axle. Here we have split ring and here we have brushes. And these brushes are further attached to a source. Okay, this is armature A, B, C, D. This is our axle. This is our split ring. This is our brush. Brush B1 and B2. Okay, similarly, this, what is this? Electric motor. Electric motor. And here we have, this is north and this is south. This is again our armature A, B, C, D. This is our armature. This is our axle. This is our axle. Okay. And this axle is attached with split rings. Like the same over here. Like this. These split rings. And they are attached with carbon brushes. And now these brushes are connected with a galvanometer. The only difference is here we rotate this in a particular direction. Here we rotate this. Due to this, the armature will rotate. Armature will rotate. And here we are giving electrical energy and we are getting mechanical energy. Here we are giving mechanical energy and we are getting electrical energy. So that you can see the basic construction construction is almost same. Here we have a source, here we have a galvanometer. Both are having split rings and brushes. Split ring and brushes are okay. This is S1, S2, B1, B2. These things are same. Connecting wire, XL, armature, permanent magnet. Rest things are same. The only difference is this, that here we have galvanometer and here we have electric motor. So you can write the same construction over here, but the principle is different. Principle is different. What is the principle for this? Or you can write it, it is a device which convert mechanical energy into electrical energy by the change of magnetic flux. by the change of magnetic flux around a coil. Around a coil, and it will cause induced current. Okay, let's see over here. I will show you. Okay, let's take the example. This is our armature A, B, C, and D. This is our armature, and this is the direction of magnetic field, north to south. Now, only this much area is interact over this north side, and this much area is interact with the south side. But now just see this much area. Okay. However, because here we have a rectangular coil. Okay. So due to this reason, we may be any shape of coil. That doesn't matter. But the shape is also vary the strength of electric generator. Okay. So in this case, this is the direction of magnetic field from north to south, and we are rotating the armature. Okay. For your convenience, let us rotate the armature in this direction. It means AB is moving in one direction. Okay. And CD is moving in outward direction. Now use Fleming right hand rule. Magnetic field in this direction. Magnetic field, direction of current, induced current in direction of motion. Motion is inward. AB is moving inward. Direction of magnetic field in this direction. So what is this direction of induced current? So we are getting induced current in downward direction over here. Similarly, the same thing, the coil is moving outward. Direction of magnetic field is north to south. So current will induced in upward direction like this. So this is the direction of induced current, like this. BCBA. This is the direction of induced current. And where this current goes, this current comes to connecting wires, then split ring, and then brushes, and then galvanometer. So you can also write one more thing, that brushes, split rings. Split ring is a commutator. Brush ring is a connector. Is making a connection between galvanometer and split ring. Okay, this is the main use of brush, you can say. Now after half rotation, okay. Now let me use the same diagram. Beta. So because almost the globe diagram is same. Okay, now this is S1. After half rotation, the S1 will reaches over here. Yes, S1 will reaches over here, and S2 comes over here. Okay. Now, and obviously this AB, and this side become D, and this side become C, and this side A, and this is your B. Got it? After half rotation, XL is not here. Okay, XL is here, and here we are rotating this. This complete is an XL, and we are rotating it. So now the CD is moving inward direction. And BA is moving in outward direction. Clear? So when CD is moving in inward direction, what happens in inward direction? The direction of current is downward. We can check it by the use of Fleming right hand rule. The direction of magnetic field is from north to south. Okay, I am using right hand rule. North to south, direction of magnetic field, and it is moving inward, and direction of current is down. So we are getting, this is direction of current. Okay. Now similarly for AB, the AB is moving outward. Direction of magnetic field north to south. Direction of current is induced, which is in upward direction. So what is the direction of current this time? ABCD. And here we have a galvanometer. So it makes a complete one cycle, or complete one rotation, and we are getting some induced current in the armature, in the galvanometer, and this complete process repeats again and again by this rotation, we are, because we are regularly rotating it. So please note it down. Okay, now we are coming to our AC generator. In AC generator, the only difference in construction is, principle is same, the only difference in construction is that here we have slip rings, not split rings. What are these? Split. Okay, put you here, you can imagine it, split. Though they are split into two parts, but next we have slip rings in our AC generator. Okay, let me write the same over there. In here we have slip rings and here we have split ring. Split, S-P-L-I-T, split. Slip and slip. This is the split. This is the difference. Okay. Yahan pe slip, full ring hai. So it is also called full ring. Full ring. Full ring. And this is your split ring. 2 TA, half half. Okay. So let's come to that diagram. AC generator. I think we move to next lecture for that. Thank you so much. In next lecture, we are discussing about AC generator and domestic circuit, only two topics. Thank you so much.